Welcome to Full Steam Ahead, a podcast about Purdue. It is time to talk Purdue baseball, and it's my privilege to welcome to the podcast one of my favorite people in the whole world, the head coach for your Purdue baseball club, Coach Greg Goff. Coach Goff, how the heck are you doing?
Well, I'm doing great, Adam. Thank you so much for having me on, man. You're getting me excited just talking with you beforehand, before we got on here. I'm so excited and very blessed to have you as a friend, and you know how much I feel about our relationship, and just glad we could get a chance to connect this morning.
Me too. I am, like you just said, feelings are the same. I've been grateful to get to know you the last couple of years and stay in touch through text, and even finally getting to meet you this last fall up at Alexander. So excited to have this conversation. The sweet tea is ready.
Yeah.
I'm ready to talk some Purdue baseball with you.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
Well, you guys are coming off a busy weekend where you had the first pitch dinner and the fan fest. Talk about those two events.
Well, you know, Adam, one thing that's really important for me is the community involvement. You know, I want our players to understand, you know, they can make a big difference in this community and people's lives. And, you know, as we go through this journey, it's more than baseball games. So, you know, we had the first pitch dinner on Friday night with a sellout. It was awesome opportunity to, you know, recognize our team for the first time kind of in public. Opportunity to have a community service award winner, which was the mayor, Rozworski of Lafayette. And then Coach Mady here on my staff was the alumni of the year. So it's a big night for our program. It's a great event and really a great way of kicking off the weekend. And then Saturday, one of my favorite days, besides the media day BP in the fall when I get to see you hit bombs. But, you know, Saturday, a chance to have Fan Fest and all the little folks coming through here. We had right at 300 people, Adam. I mean, it was a full day. Our players were dressed out in uniforms and basically had a chance to just work with the little guys and little girls. And we had a great day.
That's awesome. Such a fun event. And glad you guys are getting to do that and get doing these events back in person again. I know when we talked last year, the first pitch had to be a virtual thing. So exciting that we're getting back to normal and just getting to, you get to interact with the fans and the public in person and let them get to know your ball club, like you said. And wow, that's awesome. Glad that had a great weekend getting to do that. And we're talking about opening weekend this weekend. You guys leave tomorrow morning for the land of barbecue and sweet tea down in Sugarland, Texas. Talk about this, the excitement of getting ready for your first game.
Well, I'm excited for these players. Really, it's been a couple of years since we've had a regular season, you know, 56 games. You know, last year, the Big Ten allowed us only to play conference games. I mean, this time last year, we wasn't even playing. Everybody across the country was getting, you know, we're getting ready to open up, and we were still practicing, waiting. We hadn't even had a schedule yet. So it's so great to get back to a normal year, an opportunity for our players to have a chance to go south for the first 3 or 4 weeks, get outside and play some outside competition, you know, getting ready for the Big Ten conference schedule here in 4 weeks. So we're really thankful and excited. I'm really excited for this club. And I hope our fans and the folks around us will enjoy as much as I've enjoyed coaching them.
Yeah. And then getting to play in some warm weather too, right? Get down there in Texas, get out of the cold for a few days, right?
Yes. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. We've been outside. We got outside one time in this preseason. So probably the least amount of time that since I've been here in the 5 years. So we are really excited to be on a real baseball field with no snow and wearing some short sleeves and afterwards drinking a little sweet tea and getting some good old Texas barbecue.
There you go. You guys opening up against the South Dakota State Jackrabbits. Tell me what you know about them and just preparing for that game.
Well, I tell you, they're really good, to be honest with you. They return one of the best pitchers in the league, if not the best pitcher in the league. 2 years ago, he was a freshman All-American. Got hurt last year, was out with Tommy John surgery, and now he's returned. I mean, he's a high prospect. I'm sure we'll see him at some point Friday or Saturday. And then they return they return most of their starting lineup. I think 7 out of 9 starters are going to be offensively in their lineup, and they return 2 other weekend rotation guys for them as well. So I tell you, I mean, they're an older club, they're an experienced club, and I know talking with their coach here in the last few weeks, he's really excited about his club as well, and we'll have to show up and play some Purdue baseball to have a chance to come out on a better end.
Yeah, talk about just the excitement of getting the schedule going and getting to play an opponent, and especially like you kind of mentioned, you just touched on a minute ago, having this full schedule again now, where you get to play some non-conference opponents before getting into that meat of that the tough Big Ten schedule.
No doubt. I mean, it's you know, having a chance to just kind of, you know, figure out our lineups. I mean, to be honest with you, it's really difficult when you stay inside so much to really come out with your starting lineup. So we got a few different lineups that we'll use this weekend. And like I told our players this week, like, hey, the cream rises to the top. You know, we had an opportunity to play an opponent outside besides ourselves and, you know, go out there and win those positions. So I'm excited. We had a really good group. We brought in a lot of new guys and, you know, we have a lot of returners as well. So it's been a great combination. Those guys have got along really well. And I really appreciate the older guys really showing them, you know, what we do in our program.
Yeah, for sure. And I want to talk about, so last season, 16-26, obviously probably not the record you like.
No.
But you and I are both a glass half full guy. You finished the season very strong, winning 5 out of the last 7. And those two losses were both one run games. So you finished the season strong. Talk about taking that momentum into this season and convincing the guys, hey, we're right there. We can compete with anybody. And let's carry that into this year and build off of that.
No doubt. I mean, you know, Adam, I'm making over 5 different programs. And I've been right here where we are, picked to finish at the bottom of the league. And that's kind of what I've been able to do. I've been able to turn programs around. I've been very blessed to do those things. And we're doing that here at Purdue. I think people will see a little bit more athleticism, kind of more my style of play. And, you know, we're building this thing one day at a time. And so I think we are excited about the season. Last season, I thought was very humbling for us. But really finished strong. I really loved how our players responded. And most of those guys that were playing are back from last year. So I'm excited. You know, it's for me, it's year two as far as, you know, our team and, you know, our recruiting. Really, last year was our first recruiting class that's here this year playing for us. So we're excited.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you mentioned that I think when we talked in the fall, too, about a lot of your recruits are in now. Plus, you got some of those older seniors and stuff like that, too, that are helping. Lead the locker room and everything, and on the field, of course, too. Just talk about your team's strengths this year. Talk about your team's strengths. Talk about some of your seniors, your captains, and then, yeah, some of those newcomers that you're excited about contributing this year.
Well, you know, I think our team strength is just, you know, as I was coming down here to do this interview, I was talking with one of our seniors, and I asked him, hey, you've been here for a number of years. Like, what's the difference in this team? And he said, cohesion. You know, I think last year with COVID, the last 2 years dealing with COVID, you know, Adam, we like to do a lot of things off the field. We go camp out in the fall. We like to have a lot of things. And I just thought last year's team really missed those opportunities to grow, you know, and then you start competing right in conference play. I just felt like it really wasn't a true identity of who we are. And so this year we've been able to do all those things. We've been able to go and camp out. We've been able to go on some team bonding things. And so that, I think that's been a huge difference. And just like one of our seniors just said, the cohesion is so much better now that we're able to be around one another. I mean, we couldn't get in our locker room last year. We had to ride 2 different buses, you know, when we traveled. I mean, it was just a really difficult thing, and I'm glad our guys got through it. And so we're excited about this year's team. And really our strength, again, I think, is just our leadership. You know, we have people like Tyler Powers, Ryan Howe, those guys that have been here for 4 years, Evan Albrecht. Those guys have played a bunch of baseball, and they return. So I think I'm excited for those guys to have a chance to really play with these new guys that we got brought in here. And it's going to be exciting.
Yeah. And you talk about all that off the field cohesion. Talk about how that translates onto the field when you're, you know, trying to communicate double play balls and who's got, you know, who's catching the pop fly on that. Talk about how that off the field team building translates to on the field.
Well, it's just something I've always, you know, did in my programs. I think it's really important. If you can love that guy beside you more than you love yourself, you know, it's a we is greater than me mentality. And those are the things I try to, you know, put into our program and get our guys to buy in. You know, especially in this world today, it's about me, you know, it's about themselves a lot of times. And so, you know, I just tell them we're a band of brothers, and you got to love that guy beside you more than yourself. And you got to play for this team and this program. And those are the things that we try to, you know, invest in their players. And that's been really, you know, fun to watch this group kind of come together and put themselves second in our program and our team first.
Yeah. And you and I have talked a couple of times now about character and how important that is. Obviously, you're a man of high character, and I have a lot of respect for you. But you also try to instill that in your players as well. That helps them handle both success and struggles. And just talk about, again, that team character building.
No doubt. I mean, I think that's really important. I mean, this is a game of failure. I mean, 3 out of 10, you're in your Hall of Famer, right? You know, it's you know, crazy. And so we try to invest in our players. We try to do off, you know, we do meetings with our players. We talk about those types of things just in preparation. And I tell them all the time, man, if you can be successful in this game, it's going to translate into your relationships with your parents and your girlfriends and your friends. And when they become fathers, hopefully one day, and community leaders, you know, they will be able to fall back on some of the things that they were learned, you know, they were taught here while they were at Purdue.
That's awesome. I love you, Coach. That's so awesome. You know, obviously, you want to win baseball games. That's obviously important for your job.
There ain't no doubt. I tell you what, ain't nobody like winning more than I do. But I think there's also, I tell our guys all the time, I would never jeopardize my integrity for winning. Let's do things the right way. I want people that's associated, that sees our program, whether it's a bus driver for the first time, whether it's a, you know, somebody in a restaurant that we go in and eat to. Like, I want to make sure that we give a great impression of Purdue and Purdue University. And that's really important for me. And I think the wins will take care of itself, Adam. We're going to get good players. This is a great place to recruit for, one of the best I've ever had. As far as facilities and school and the administration support. So we're get the wins, but I just think it's more about the relationships and helping these guys get prepared for after college when they get out into the real world.
That's awesome. Coach, well said. I love that and I respect that so much. And you talked about recruiting tools and a great place to play. One of those things, those recruiting tools includes Alexander Field. I finally got the pleasure of getting up there this fall for that media BP lunch day.
That's right. Didn't you hit one out? Didn't you hit one out, Alexander?
I got one out of the outfield at least.
That's awesome.
That was such a fun day. I was so blessed to be a part of that. And I was just blown away by Alexander Field and the facilities up there. I said it was my first time getting to see it. What a recruiting tool for players to be able to play there. Talk about Alexander Field, period. And then let's, after that, get into this exciting announcement I saw about the new a video board you guys are going to get to feature this year. Talk about Alexander.
Well, it's a great, great venue. I think it's the best in the Big Ten and one of the best in the country, to be honest with you. We have a natural grass, which is different than most places in the Big Ten. So it prepares our guys to get a chance, if they get a chance to play professionally, to be able to handle that. I think the scouts appreciate that when they can see them play on dirt. But just like last year, I mean, it was a COVID year and we sold out every game with the amount of people that we were allowed to come into the stadium. These Purdue fans, as you know, that's why I love it here. They're so fanatic about the Boilermakers and what they're doing. And they showed up last year for us. And so those are the things that make the atmosphere at Alexander such a great place. I love walking out there every day. It's such an honor and privilege for me to put that uniform on and represent our Boilermaker family and nation. And as you said, the video board, I came through last night after doing my Valentine. I did my Valentines with my wife and my girls, but went by the field last night to get a couple of things. And they were all out there. The big trucks are here. The video board is being erected as we speak. And I just can't wait for our fans to have a chance to have that interaction with us to include that atmosphere at Alexander.
That's awesome. And talk about that fan experience and the importance of the fans too. You know, Folk Field's right next door, and you know, the soccer, the Purdue women's soccer program had such a fantastic year this fall. And just seeing the fans and especially the students get behind them and supporting them and being out there through all those games. Talk about getting that out to Alexander as well and just what that means for your ball club.
Well, I think it's a huge deal. You know, we'll be on the road for the first, you know, 4 weeks. Mm-hmm. And when we get back home, we're excited about seeing all those folks and being in those stands. I mean, it makes a big difference in baseball. It's a game of momentum, as you know, and whenever you have those fans yelling for you and getting after the opponent a little bit, that's what it's all about. And you know, just again, having a facility to be able to walk out there and play is such an awesome thing, and that's one of the reasons why I stayed here and felt like, you know, we can do some really, really good things here as we build this program.
That's awesome. Have you talked to your team about goals this year?
We talk about those things, but really for me, I talk about just being your best every day, putting in the work, getting more involved in the process instead of the outcome. I think a lot of times, you know, even when I was a young coach, I look at a 56 game schedule and go through, hey, we should win 35 or 40. And I think a lot of times you get kind of caught up in that stuff and you lose a game you didn't supposed to and you get emotional. So I really, as I've kind of gone through this thing, just really tell our guys about the process. Let's build on the process. Let's buy into the process. You know, don't count the days till we get there, but make every day count mentality, Adam. And so, you know, our goal is to show up every day, play as hard as we can every day, be efficient in what we do, you know, have a great team at bats. And, you know, the big scoreboard, the big monster out there will reward us if we do things right.
That's awesome. Coach, man, I love it. I was going to ask you to you know, sell a fan on a game, but I think you just done that. I mean, listening to you get me pumped up, makes me want to play for you. So,
well, I appreciate that. I love what I do. You know, I tell all our recruits, I tell everybody, you know, I'm 51 years old, Adam. I hadn't had to work a day in my life. I've been very blessed. The good Lord has blessed me with an opportunity to coach. And I don't take that lightly. Every day I wake up and it's an honor to do what I do and just try to, you know, have a positive outcome on my players and the people around us.
I love it. Love it, Coach. Hey, as we're kind of wrapping up here, I want to,
yeah,
you know, we keep talking about this character thing. You talk about how blessed you are and just love you as a person. I got to see a really cool thing you guys did this past, I think it was like late fall, maybe early winter with Team Impact and Graham. And I apologize if I mess up the last name, Graham Tayama. Talk about that. That was so cool. Anybody who's watching this on our website, I will include a link to that so people can see that as well. Maybe put some video over as you're kind of explaining this, but just talk about that partnership with Team Impact and that day with recruiting Graham. That was really awesome.
Well, you know, it was 2 years coming. I mean, it took us 2 years to find the right recruit, and we finally found him. And I knew as soon as I talked with, you know, Graham's family and him, I knew, man, this is an awesome relationship that's going to be. And so what we do with Team Impact is they pair us. They find a young man that loves baseball and loves Purdue. And so we recruit him, and then we sign him to a national letter of intent. So he's now official Boilermaker. We made him that day on his, you know, we had a press conference that day and allowed everybody to meet him. What a awesome young man that really, you know, again, makes you appreciate what we're doing and how we can do it. And he's a huge factor in our team. I'll tell you what, he was up here for our first pitch dinner this Friday, and we had a big picture of him with him and his family and so forth. And we have a locker in the locker room for him and all those things. I mean, he's a part of our team, and we're really excited about him joining it.
That's really cool, man. Coach, I love just seeing that and seeing your impact on the community and just and getting to do things like that. It's such awesome. Again, I think it speaks to your character especially, but also just the character of a Purdue University and what they're all about as well. So that's really awesome. I just want to make sure our audience had a chance to hear about that. And if, like I said, if they want to go to our website and see the full video, I'll put a link to that on there as well, because that was just a really cool thing you guys did.
Great.
Awesome. Coach, as we're wrapping up, anything else you want to add?
No, I'm just so thankful. I really appreciate our time, and I'm excited. I can't wait. I can't wait to get back home after the next 3 or 4 weeks and have a chance to get in front of our Boilermaker Nation and get out here and let our fans see why I'm so proud of this team and excited about the season.
That's for sure. And I will also include a link to the schedule on the website as well. Of course, Friday, March 11th, that home opener against Bellarmine. Looking forward to that, kicking off Alexander Field for the season again in front of that big video board and the fans, and that is the beautiful facility that it is. So. Coach.
Awesome. Coach, thank you so much, Adam. You guys have a great day.
Hey, you too, man. Got the jersey ready for Friday. Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go.
Boiler up.
Thank you.